And with the fourth, rather, President Duterte had been harping about his quest to end the country's drug problems in his past three saunas. He has promised time and again that the war on drugs will be unrelenting. Let's take a quick look at the past year's anti-drug operations with Marianne Enriquez.
We will not stop until the last drug lord, the last financier, and the last pusher have surrendered or put behind bars or below the ground if they so wish. The fight will be unremitting. Let me begin by putting it bluntly. The war against illegal drugs is far from over.
Since his first State of the Nation address, President Rodrigo Duterte never fails to mention his war against illegal drugs. But until now, the campaign continues to face criticism. Thousands have been killed in his drug war. But it is hard to pin the exact number because it varies depending on whose data you will base on.
We do not remove the possibility na mas mataas pa than 6,600 if you add those fatalities committed by vigilantes. Tinitignan pa rin at sinusukat yung naging response ng pamahalaan dito kasi kahit na hindi sila yung direct perpetrator.
I feel bad for the UNHCR for being misinformed, no? Kasi nga, we have cleared that over time that the HCUI's 16,000 of that is in fact homicide cases which are also investigated by the Philippine National Police.
But critics say they can't help but notice a pattern in the drug war stories. Some of the controversial cases involve teenagers who allegedly fought back. And even few weeks before the sauna of Duterte, another incident involving a drug operation earned the ire of human rights groups, the death of the three-year-old girl Micah Olpina. On June 29, Micah was caught in a crossfire between police officers and her father, who was the target of the drug operation. While the police said Micah was used as a human shield, the toddler's mother claims otherwise.
Susuko na raw siya, susuko na kasi may tama na yung bata, pabayaan na. Ang ginawa nila, nagpapatok pa rin, karga ang bata.
The PNP said they do not tolerate erring cops.
We see it through. We want to make sure that all these responsible people, policeman yan o hindi, has been filed with cases. And we have done just that.
PNP Deputy Spokesperson Kim Molitas adds that if people were to base the success of the drug war on the numbers, people would see the government is actually winning. But human rights groups continue to argue that the drug war can't be considered a success as long as people continue to die during the operations.
Mas marami namang talagang panalo kung walang droga talaga sa lipunan. Kaya lang yung pamamaraan, yun nga yung sabi natin, pwede namang gawin yung kampanya laban sa droga nang walang namamatay. Mas mainam iyon at mas wala pang magiging issue sa gayong usapin.
In spite of the criticism, President Duterte is still bent on continuing the drug war until his term ends.
I'm asking the human rights people, is it wrong to say, if you destroy my country, I will kill you? Is that a crime? I have been telling this to everyone time and again, maybe for the end time before you. Now you just do your duty in according to the books. And you do not have to worry about cases. Basta sa trabaho, akin yan. As long as there are no abuses.
For News 5, Marian Enriquez, we are One News.